Hey, this is Anthony from RevZilla. You can watch, decide, and ride. Welcome to our detailed breakdown of the new Alpinestars Streetwise Drystar pant, available at RevZilla.com. This is the Streetwise. We dig it. New for the spring of 18, coming in under the $250 mark, the Streetwise does the basics extremely well. We consider this a mid-range, temperate season touring commuting pant. Why do we say that? This is gonna be Drystar, waterproof, breathable. It has a couple of direct vents. That's a nice touch. It's not a full bonded liner. It's going to be a floating liner, but they did give you direct vents, so you can keep it cooler. Stretch it later in the spring, maybe early summer. You also have a full length thermal. So in the fall and in the spring, when it's nippy out, you can rock this as well. Extreme cold of the winter, extreme cold of the summer, or heat of the summer, it's not gonna work. That's why we call it a mid-range pant. But ultimately, CE level one bio armor. You have room to put in CE level one hip protectors, part of the Nucleon series from Alpinestars. You have a great reflective scheme and it just works without breaking the bank. We dig it. Now I have high-vis Brian to my left. You're gonna have to trust me. He's cut off from the waist up. You can't see him. 6'1", 195. In a pair of Wranglers, he's a 33-inch jeans waist. If you measure his belly button, he's 35 inches. He's about a 32-inch inseam. He's wearing a size large. If you use the size chart, he comes in right between a medium and a large. He went a size up. It has liners. Ultimately, that was the right move for him, but that's pretty consistent. He's typically a large in Alpinestars. Keep that in mind. Use the size chart. We'll ship free over $39. I love it if you click our logo, subscribe to us at RevZilla on our YouTube channel. Leave me your comments, requests, your feedback on the new Streetwise Drystar. Now, keep in mind, too, if you need a little more stretch, if you're a little bit beefier, you go with something like the Hyper Drystar, which gives you more stretch in around the crotch area. That's where the stretch is, and it works. It's a little bit more of a dynamic cut. Now, back to the pant itself. Snap in a slide up here because you have a big gaiter at the crotch, and again, you have that baked in waterproof breathability. It's non-removable. I will tell you, one of the things I love, and one of the things it's kind of my gripe with this pant, is that this ventilation system right here, these vents are direct vents, directly vented to the leg. So through the waterproof breathable liner. That's awesome. You get more warm weather riding out of it. But if you were to buy this pant in, say, the Pacific Northwest, where you're getting rained on all the time, anything more than the cloudburst, at speed, 20-minute downpour or more, you're probably gonna have some rain that gets in here. It's not a fully shielded zipper. It's not a waterproof zipper, a water-resistant zipper. So we looked at that and we said, great, they're optimizing for ventilation and giving you more of a warm weather seasonality, but if you really need the waterproofing, there are other pants from Alpinestars you're gonna invest a little bit more that might become Gore-Tex or have a different rating that still gives you the airflow, but it'd do a better job blocking the water. So that would be our big gripe on this pant, if we had one. Other than that, though, you're not investing it even over the $250 mark. So again, it's all trade-offs. You have to think about bang for the buck factor versus technicality for the craziest of climates. Again, you know where that falls. Slash pockets up here towards the top, adjustability up here at the waist, again, allowing you to not have to wear a belt. 600D in our impact areas, 450D in your main construction areas, which is a nice touch. Hi, Brian, turn face that away for me. Notice 2 points of adjustment, and they did reflective on those adjusters. You have back of the thigh and back of the calf. It's nice. And your lateral side for your entry and exit point. Remember, this is a waterproof liner, so when I open that up, the gusset is waterproof all the way down. And right now, he does have the full thermal installed. Turn and face backwards for me. Big accordion panel, top of the seat at the yoke, Alpinestars logo. Notice you have a nice tall back here. It's gonna be wicking. And you do have a double reinforced butt. That's a nice touch. 600D, plus you have the butt grippers for a little bit more tactile response if you're riding and you get rained on. Notice it's a clean line down the back. It's gonna be 450 throughout. Come back around to the front for me. So all in, remember, spring, fall, rock solid. Beginning of summer, good to go. Middle of summer, not gonna work for you. Beginning of winter, probably good to go. Middle of winter, when it gets really cold, not gonna work. And extended downpours all the time, you're gonna get some leakage on your thigh. Keep it in mind. Make a smart choice and really look at the pants that might be a couple steps up from this as you start evaluating how much that waterproofing means to you compared to the trade-off with the ventilation. But ultimately, the Streetwise Drystar, rock solid pant, executed really well, and you can beef up the hip armor. We don't have a lot of issues with it. And I like the way they did the reflective scheme, very tasteful, but also functional. The next step in your journey is to click the info button, your desktop, your mobile device, visit the product detail page at RevZilla.com, read other rider reviews. Shouldn't just take my word for it. As always, we'll ship free over $39. If you want to talk to a gear geek, see us at RevZilla.com or 877-792-9455. Thanks for watching our detailed breakdown. Remember, subscribe to us at RevZilla on our YouTube channel to stay up to date with our opinion. Latest and greatest in the motor universe, I'm Anthony. We'll see you next time.